Hey, Out Late But Great, this is Jim here from Ohio, and it is Friday, and I am your host on Fridays on the channel Out Late But Great. So this is an open topic week, and I decided to talk about something that really kind of got to my heart just this past weekend. For probably about 10 years or so ago, we've been involved in this, and they have it every year. Well, it all started out, a good friend of ours and his wife, they were a couple, they were both good friends of ours. The husband committed suicide and left behind his wife and their two children, who were adolescents at the time. So after that event happened, the wife, who still is a good, very, very good friend of ours, she started participating in a group called Life Act, which is in the greater Cleveland area, northeastern Ohio area. And it's basically a support group for family members and friends that are left after their loved ones commit suicide. And it talks, you know, it's funny, when we first started going there probably were about 200 people there. And last Sunday, they had the event, and there were at least over 2,000 people. And they were talking about just about how depression is a big silent killer in our society, and nobody really talks about it. They said that one of the biggest causes of death between 14 and 22-year-olds isn't car accidents or illness or whatever, it's suicide. And it's so much more prevalent than we think. So one of the main speaker that they had, they always have a speaker. And the main speaker was this woman. Her name was Amanda Gist. I'd never heard of her before, but she is an actress in Hollywood. And she was talking about her experiences with depression and, you know, being in the Hollywood scene and, you know, going to apply for jobs and people telling you that you're not a good enough actor, you're not a good enough actress, and She spiraled into this depression, and she said the one time that went, in one of her interviews, they said, "Where do you see yourself in 5 years?" Which is a common question that people do ask for interviews. And she decided to go for help because she thought to herself, "In 5 years, I will be dead if I keep living this lifestyle that I'm living with this depression." She was talking about how, you know, she would starve herself. She became bulimic and anorexic and whatever, just to get jobs, to make herself look cool and good. And she was talking about social media, and, you know, we all do this. Those of us that have Facebook or even this channel, on her Facebook page, everything looked wonderful and happy, and, you know, she was eating salads and working out, when in fact, she said, "I was lying in bed with the drapes pulled and eating tons of chips and hamburgers, and then I would go throw it up." And she said that, so that made everybody laugh, because for those of us that do have social media accounts, it's true. I mean, you only put the best things out there. So anyway, she did go and seek help, and she just wanted to tell her story because, like I said, you know, depression is just really rampant in our society, and it will kill you. If you don't commit suicide, then you may turn to drugs or alcohol or whatever, and it's sad because there are things out there to help you. There's medication, there's counseling, you know. I'm married to a counselor, so I know that these things do really help. And it's better to get back on track, because if you decide to commit suicide, you don't know, yeah, you're releasing your pain, but you're really hurting the people that you leave behind. You really are. It was so sad after the meeting last weekend. It was actually at the Cleveland Zoo, if you've ever been there before. But there are trails, and they wanted you to take a walk through these trails. And all along the trails, they had put pictures of people that victims of suicide, and it just broke your heart. I mean, you see pictures of these young people that, you know, they haven't even reached the age of 20 yet, and they're gone. And it's awful. It really is. So that's why I wanted to talk to you about that. If you are in that shape, and you know, being in the LGBT community is it brings on depression, especially with a society that doesn't like you, especially in the trans society. I mean, that there are records out there that say that, you know, trans people are, I think, 1 in 2 almost attempt suicide at one point in their life. And you know, it's really tough, and it's sad. It really is. And you know, if you're gay and you're closeted and you're living a lie, like that woman, you know, on her social media account pretending that everything's a certain way, and in reality it's not, that really wears you down. It really does. So hopefully more people will take advantage of the resources that are out there, I hope. So anyway, guys, that's all I got to say. It is just about 80 degrees out, and I actually did cut the grass, and the flowers are blooming, and I'm just glad spring's here. And that was another thing, too. They used to have this meeting in the fall, which was kind of sad, because here in the Northern Hemisphere, everything is dying. But they had this walk last Sunday, and it was kind of refreshing, because it was life renewing itself. You know, the trees were blooming, and the birds were singing, and it kind of gave you a better outlook on depression. So anyway, guys, that's all I got to say. Take care, love you, and I will talk to you next Friday. Bye-bye.